Hello everyone, welcome to our broadcast on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. I'm Yang Yuchen with Xinhua News Agency. Here I am, Kuangzigou Village, ethnic Man, Autonomous County of Qingyuan, Northeast China's Liaoning Province. Under the poverty alleviation work, this village turned into a scenic resort 5 years ago. Villagers' lives were totally changed. Today, you can follow us to walk around Qingyuan. Let's enjoy this amazing view and take a look at people's life here. Today, we have Mr. Chen Xuanyi with us. He will be our guide today. 你好，陈书记。
你好。
So Mr. Chen is the first party secretary of Qingyuan Village, which is also known as the head of the poverty alleviation work team. Actually, the moment I got off the car today, I can feel that the air is pretty fresh. 陈书记，我今天一下车我就发现咱们这空气特别的清新，咱们这自然条件是不是挺好的？您能不能给我介绍一下咱们这自然条件情况？
好的，啊，我们这里那个坐落在这个矿子沟生态风景区里，我们这里的有85平方公里的森林覆盖率，啊，负氧85平方公里。森林覆盖率达到81%，啊，是一个天然的大氧吧，负氧离子特别好，然后特别受到外来游客的欢迎。
So Mr. Chen just told me that Qingyuan Scenic Resort covers an area of about 85 square kilometers, and the forest coverage rate here is over 80%. The oxygen content is pretty high here, so the air is very fresh.And lots of tourists come here to visit.
陈书记，那咱这自然条件这么好，是不是也给咱这个建立矿子沟风景区打下了一个特别良好基础？那咱们这块的这个风景区是哪年建立，然后哪年开放的呀
？So when did the scenic resort open to the public?
啊，我们这个矿子沟生态风景区啊，是2015年开始投入建设的。啊，到现在呢，历时五年呢，经营五年了之后，已初具规模，已被评为国家级4A级生态风景区。
And so the scenic resort was built in 2015 and officially opened to the public in 2016. And for now, this Qingyuan Scenic Resort is already evaluated as a high level.Scenic resort by our country.
陈书记，那咱们现在这块是一个风景如画的一个景区哈，这儿生态旅游业也是这个一个算是一个支柱产业了。那么以前在建景区之前，咱们村主要是依靠什么产业？然后老百姓主要是依靠什么来生存呢
？So what is the major industry? What was the major industry before the establishment of this?
啊，咱们这个村啊，原来是最穷的一个村，因为我们这里的村吧，有300户人家，889口人，耕地面积呢只有1400多亩，平均每个人只有1亩3分地儿，啊，照这样的话呢，村民的主要收入来源呢只有这个种地和外出务工，啊，现在自从有了景区之后，可以依托景区。很多村民呢，搞起了农家院啊，开启了民宿啊，啊，收取停车费啊等等，还有的呢，啊，做起了小买卖，啊，卖点这个山野菜呀、蘑菇啊、土特产品等等，来增加收入。
And so Qingyuan Village was once a very small village with a population about nearly 900, and they once lived on their small farmland, and they just worked outside the.A small village in the urban areas, but after the establishment of this scenic resort, lots of villagers started to open their homestays, started to open restaurants and sell specialties to the tourists, and they even developed their yards into parking space for the tourists.
陈书记，那就是。咱们这儿这个贫困户现在就这几年的这个一个情况大概是什么样？咱们这儿贫困户的一些基本情况，还有就是这几年咱们是 这些贫困户是因何致贫，然后这几年咱们政府啊又是怎么帮助这些贫困户脱贫致富的呢？
我们这村的贫困户啊，大部分都是因病啊、因残呐、致贫的，因为因病因残呐、缺少劳动能力啊，就没有这个收入来源。然后咱们这几年脱贫呢，主要还是依靠啊党和政府啊出台了一系列的脱贫政策，就是扶贫政策啊，像咱们这个把这个产业扶贫这块，把产业扶贫资金呢投入到景区。然后呢，让每名贫困户啊，分得这个分红收益啊，从而增加稳定收入啊，帮助他们稳定脱贫啊。最主要还有一块是这个医疗扶贫啊，这个咱贫困户啊，这个这岁数大了，然后那个长期啊有慢性病啊，吃药这个支出非常高，这个费用，然后没有钱承受不了。自从国家出台了这个医疗扶贫政策之后啊，许多贫困户啊，就是看病啊。就是吃药啊，到最后了一报销，个人只承担很小的一部分啊，这为他们生活呀解决了很大的帮助，生活质量明显提高。
So according to Mr. Chen, thanks to the various policies by the government and by the poverty alleviation, lots of impoverished households got rid of poverty in recent years.And in terms of the medical care, they can get medicines for free from the local hospital, and they barely spend nothing on the medical care. And as the scenic resort developed this year, impoverished households can get a bonus from the scenic resort.But without any input, and they have tons of opportunities in this scenic resort.
陈书记，那咱们就是这几年是帮助了大概是多少户或者多少名的贫困人口脱贫了呢？
我们那个村啊有20户，37口人啊。我们这个建档那个贫困户啊已经全部脱贫了啊，这是今年底。
So totally, Qingyuan village has about 20 households which were in poverty, but now they are all lifted out of poverty in recent years.
陈书记，刚刚听您说这个，咱们这块就是开办民宿是一个比较重要的一个，就是一个居民的一个算是一个收入来源。然后呢，咱们现在这个民宿现在是一个大概一个什么情况
？So I was wondering about the situation of the homestays in Qingyuan village.
我们这里现在身处的这家就是一个民宿啊。一会儿呢，我们邀请这个老板能给大家讲解一下。
So now actually we are now in the homestay and we just have the owner of this homestay with us and let him to give us a tour. So we have the owner of this homestay, Mr. Zhu with us.
那个朱大哥您好，然后请您那个带我们逛逛您家民宿，好吧？
好，我领你们去看看咱的房间。
Okay, so let him show us around his homestay. Let's go.
朱大哥，咱家是我听说是第一家开办民宿的，是吗？
对对对，咱们是有这个景区，咱家是头一家开办那个。
So Mr. Zhu is the first one to open homestay in Qingyuan village.
咱家是哪年开始有这个民宿的？
咱们这个是民宿是从2015年有旅游区了，咱那时候就有这个民宿。
So Mr. Zhu's homestay it was opened in 2015.
然后朱大哥，这块是咱们家是现在是一共是有几间屋子开放给游客？
现在咱们家是一共有10间房住的客房。
So there are 10 rooms open for tourists. 然后朱大哥，我们看一下这个里边的房。So let's have a look of this room. So we can see that there is a big bed in this room. Well, it is a very local one called 土炕，是吧，朱大哥？
对对对，咱们这是农村的土炕，烧木柴。炕是烧完之后是热乎。
So this kind of bed is heated by the wooden by the wood. So you can add some wood under the bed, and after they are fired, and you can feel the temperature. 然后朱大哥，咱们这个我看这个，这是卫生间，也是很整洁，是吧？咱们能开一下灯吗 ？So can we open the light? Here, and tourists can.Take a shower. Zhuo 哥，咱家这个一般这样的一间房，它这个收费大概是多少 ？So what is about the room rate of this room?
咱们这个客房嘛，咱是。淡季时候呢，这一个客房100块钱一间。到十月一长假期间呢，客流量能多了呢，咱们就能贵一点，200块钱一个房间。
So the room rate is about 100 yuan per night during the low season. But during the high season, especially like Golden Week holiday, this kind of room, the room rate could reach about 200 yuan per night.那朱大哥，咱家这个房间就是这么多，那像十一期间是不是还比较火爆？是需要预定吗？
咱们这十月一长假期间客流量能多点，都有回头客，他都来过咱家的，提前就预定好哪天来，咱就把房间给留下。要是当天来呢，咱们这接待能力还是少，客房就不够用了。
So during the Golden Week holiday, there are so many tourists come here, and some of them even come here for twice or for the third time. So the tourists have to make a reservation in advance. 朱大哥，那咱往外边看一看，好吧？我发现您家是除了这个平时这个住宿的这个屋子以外啊，我看对面还有餐厅是吧？
对对对，咱们对面是招待客人吃饭就是用餐的地方。
So we can see that there is also restaurant in Mr. Zhu's homestay. Mr. Zhu just told me that the tourists who lived in his homestay.can have three meals in this restaurant. They offer various dishes for the tourists.
朱大哥，咱家就是以前在开办咱民宿之前，您主要是做什么的呀？
咱们以前没有这景区之前吧，都是种地、种玉米，打点零工，维持生活。
So before Mr. Zhu opened this.Homestay, who once lived on his farmland, and he also worked in the urban areas. But now he came back to his hometown and opened this homestay.
朱大哥，那咱们这个，您觉得就是这个景区开办之后啊，您开了这个民宿，您觉得这个生活上？跟以前比是有什么变化？您的收入啊，生活状态？
这得比以前好多了。以前你就种地，咱这山区地也少，一年就是够个生活费。现在有这个饭店了，有这旅游区，有这饭店和住宿了，咱这年收入得比以前得怎么得翻一倍了。现在就是收入也高了，生活也比以前好了。
After the establishment of the scenic resort.Mr. Zhu's income doubled compared to before, and Mr. Zhu said that he is very satisfied with nowadays life. And 朱大哥，那就是说您对以后咱们矿子沟村景区这个发展 这个您的这个信心或者说是您的期待是有一个那个提高吗？
嗯，这个咱说实话希望越来越好啊。这个咱们现在这个景区吧，就是能半年的时间客流量，要是以后冬天有什么项目了，常年有了，收入不就更高了吗？
嗯嗯。So Mr. Zhu deeply hopes that in the future, the scenic resort can have more opportunities to welcome more tourists, so that they can raise their revenue more. So.Today, this is the end of our tour in this homestay. And this is the life of these villagers who open homestays and open restaurants. But what about those villagers who haven't opened their homestay? What about the normal villagers' life? So let's go have a look.
刘大爷在家吗？
哎，在家。啊，崔叔也来了，正
好有记者来采访。
好好好，欢迎欢迎，来欢迎欢迎，好，好欢迎，屋里请来。
啊，对对。
啊，来，屋里请，屋里请。
哎，大娘您好。
嗨。
哎，里边坐，里边坐。
So here we come to Mr. and Mrs. Liu's house. As we can see that Mrs. Liu is preparing for their lunch today.
阿姨您现在是在做什么呢？
做粘豆包。
哦，咱们这个粘豆包是东北的一个特色是吗？
是东北特色。
So Mrs. Liu just told me that she is making a special local food called 粘豆包 which is also known as the sticky red bean buns. It's a very local food in northeast China and is also an ethnic Man food.阿姨，这个您能给我这个介绍一下这个咱们这个制作粘豆包的一些食材吗？
那个，
这个是
粘苞米和粘大米。
So this is the dough which is mixed by sticky rice flour and corn flour. It will turn into the crust of 粘豆包。阿姨，那这个是咱的馅儿，
小豆馅儿。这东北都这么做，小豆馅儿和那个。这那个米包，就是咱们冬天哈，就都是家家户户的闹尿勺，那蒸豆包都是这个。
So this is the red bean fillings. This kind of red beans are very special. They have smaller size, and compared to the normal ones, this kind of red beans have more fresh fragrance, and it is already crushed into paste.And Mrs. Liu is turning them into balls. 阿姨，那咱们这个做完这个馅儿之后，下一步是要把这个米
面，面就可以包了。这不都把馅儿转成团了吗？要是烙尿勺就不用了。烙尿勺直接就按到面里就可以了。
阿姨，那您现在就是，咱能现在先包一个吗？
包一个，
包一个试试看。
洗澡的啊，要不就看看。行，那个面有点小，不够干啥？你也算。你这里咱手这么一点一点往前的吗？
你帮他捏，
对，
我帮
你
捏吗？
他手我手，正哎，这，这这么一点点，这个玩意儿哈，越整越细，你在你手里越拖越细，整来整去整成个了就。
So now I have my first sticky red bean buns, 粘豆包. So let's put it here. I have noticed that the decoration outside Mr. and Mrs. Liu's house is pretty new. Actually, housing reinforcement and renovation are crucial parts of poverty alleviation work in China. This is just a glimpse of people's better life after being lifted out of poverty in China. Hundreds of millions of people benefit from the poverty alleviation work. And we will show you more about this in the future. So, this is the end of today's visit. I sincerely hope that Mr. and Mrs. Liu's life will get better and better. Don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Thanks for watching, and we will see you next time.
2016到2020年，中央财政连续五年每年都增加专项扶贫资金200亿元，累计投入了5300多亿元，带动地方投入了8000多亿元。今年受新冠肺炎疫情等多方面因素的影响，财政的收支形势确实较为严峻。今年中央财政的专项扶贫资金不降反增，达到了1461亿元，而且另外安排了一次性的脱贫攻坚补短板的资金300亿元。财政部始终把强化扶贫资金监管摆在突出的位置，确保每笔扶贫资金用到实处，用得其所，用出效应。